Anyone who belongs to Christ has become a new person. The old life is gone, a new life has begun. And all of this is a gift from God who brought us back to himself through Christ. For God was in Christ, reconciling the world to himself through Christ's promise of forgiveness of sin.
This is the power of the cross.
God's people had long awaited the coming of Christ. Suffering under the oppressive Roman regime, they found hope in the words of Jesus, "The kingdom of heaven is at hand." Thinking he would establish an earthly kingdom where they would be free from Roman oppression, they prepared to welcome their new king into Jerusalem.
A very large crowd spread cloaks and branches on the road as Jesus entered the city. Surrounding him, they shouted, "Hosanna to the Son of David! Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord! Hosanna in the highest!"
Hosanna!
Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna.
cheers faded quickly as the events of the following week began to unfold. Knowing the end was near, Jesus prepared for a final meal with his disciples. He took some bread and gave thanks to God for it. Then he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "This is my body, which is given for you. Do this to remember me."
After supper, he took a cup of wine and said, "This is the new covenant between God and his people, an agreement confirmed with my blood, which is poured out as a sacrifice for you. When you drink this, remember me."
The closeness of that last meal with his disciples was short-lived, for that very night Judas took action to betray Jesus. Peter, one of his most loyal friends, denied him not once but three times as religious leaders in Jerusalem provoked the government officials to have Jesus arrested.
Knowing what lay ahead for him, Jesus withdrew to an olive grove to pray. "Abba, Father," he cried out, "for you everything is possible. Please take this cup of suffering away from me. Yet I want your will to be done, not mine."
Mm-hmm. The stillness of the night was shattered as soldiers came to arrest Jesus, whom Judas betrayed with a kiss. Jesus was brought before the Roman governor Pilate to stand trial. Pressured by angry crowds who had been incited by the chief priests, Pilate condemned Jesus to death by crucifixion.
Two criminals were crucified with him, one on his right, one on his left. People passing by mocked him, shouting, "You said you were going to destroy the temple and rebuild it in 3 days. If you are the Son of God, save yourself and come down from the cross."
The religious leaders also mocked Jesus. "He saved others," they scoffed, "but he can't save himself. He said, 'I am the Son of God,' so let God rescue him. If he will come down from the cross right now, we will believe in him." At noon, darkness came over the whole land until 3 p.m. Then the curtain of the temple was torn in two. Jesus called out with a loud voice, "Father, into your hands I commit my spirit." Then he breathed his last.
Many women who had come to care for Jesus were watching from a distance, including Mary Magdalene, Mary, the mother of James and Joseph, and Mary, the mother of Jesus. What anguish Mary must have felt as she watched the lifeless body of her son be lifted from the cross.
How can this be? Why must this be? I will hold a baby boy. He'll embrace the world. I will shield you from the bitter cold. I will keep you from the frightening noise. I'll protect you from the pain and hurt. I will hold you when you are alone. You try to teach them, and they silenced your voice. You reached out to touch them, and they pierced your hand. You came to love them, and they broke your heart. Oh, Lord Jehovah, behold your son. See what the hatred of mankind has done. I could not shield you from the coldness of men's hearts. I could not keep you from the noise of human rage. I couldn't protect you from the pain of nails and thorns, from this journey toward death that you have walked. Every day since you were born, all I can do now is to hold you, love you, my
Late on Friday afternoon, the day of preparation for the Sabbath, Nicodemus and Joseph of Arimathea buried the body of Jesus.
The women from Galilee followed them to a tomb. Then they went home and prepared spices and ointments to embalm him.